So we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and bearing witness that none has the right to be worshipped or unconditionally obeyed except for Him. And we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His final messenger. We ask Allah to send His peace and blessings upon Him, the prophets and messengers that came before Him, His family and companions that served alongside Him, and those that follow in His blessed path until the Day of Judgment. And we ask Allah to make us amongst them. Allahumma ameen. Dear brothers and sisters, I'm going to start off with a sentence that I want you to remember, inshallah ta'ala, and that will make sense by the end of the khutbah. Something you did, something you gave, something that was taken away from you. Three things. Something you did, something you gave, something that was taken away from you. Now let me explain what this means in the capacity of this khutbah. I had an entirely different khutbah planned, and then I saw a video of a man who we see as possibly being one of the awliya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as there are many of them in Gaza. An older man named Khalid, who was playing with his daughter, who's actually his granddaughter, but in the Sharia, the grandfather is the father, the granddaughter is the daughter, the grandmother is the mother. It is all one line, and it is the same reward, it is the same ihtisab, and that's one of the beautiful things about Islam, that connection goes through the entire line. And as he was holding his daughter, of course, his granddaughter, and speaking those final words to her, kissing her eye, the soul of my soul, I saw another video of him today, and I think many of you might have seen it, where he was comforting another girl. And this was a girl who had lost one of her legs. And he was comforting her by saying to her, your leg is already in Jannah. Your leg has already preceded you to Jannah. And it got me thinking about this concept that we have in Islam, and subhanAllah, it's so comprehensive, where many of us might say, and I've heard this sentiment, you know, I understand the shuhada, alhamdulillah, they didn't suffer too much. You hear this concept multiple times, right? When someone passes away, did they suffer? Did they suffer? And sometimes you see people that survive, and you think to yourself, if I was that person, I'd probably wish I didn't survive. I probably wish I basically passed away. And you see some of the people that survived, but with what? Right? Survived, but under horrific circumstances, and perhaps they too wish they could have been from the shuhada. They too wish that they would have just passed away and transitioned to that promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way that their family members have transitioned. But look at how comprehensive this deen is. And I start off with this part, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that on the Day of Judgment, يُؤْتَى بِأَشَدِّ النَّاسِ بَلَاءً, a person who had the worst suffering and trial and tribulation in this world would be brought forward. Some of the scholars say Ayyub alayhi salam is that person and is dipped in Jannah one time. And the question to that person after they're dipped in Jannah one time is not, hey, does your arm still hurt? Go ahead and do this for me, right? Like if you woke up in a hospital, kick your leg forward. Can you chew? Can you hear? Do you have all of your senses back? What's the question? هَلْ رَأَيْتَ بُؤْسًا قَتْ? Have you ever seen sadness? SubhanAllah. Have you ever seen deprivation? And the answer is, I don't even know what sadness is. I don't remember any of it. From one dip in Jannah. And that is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who does not break any of His promises, that Allah azza wa jal will restore everything in a person, and Allah's promise is true, and His reward is sufficient. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel means not just that Allah is sufficient, that means that by extension, everything that Allah has promised is sufficient in place of the trials and the tribulations that we face in this life. But I want to come back to this one concept. Can a part of me be in Jannah before the whole of me be in Jannah? And I gave you three things in the very beginning of this khutbah. And I take it back to the Battle of Uhud once again. There were some people who survived Uhud, but they were already shuhada. One of them, the most famous of them, was Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the one who was catching arrows in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of Uhud, who suffered over 70 wounds and collapsed, but somehow he woke up. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at him and he said, مَنْ سَرَّهُ أَنْ يَنْظُرَ إِلَى شَهِيدٍ يَمْشِي عَلَى وَجْهِ الْأَرْضِ فَلْيَنْظُرْ إِلَى طَلْحَةَ بْنُ عُبَيْدِ اللَّهِ. Whoever wants to see a walking shaheed, look at Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Some of the people that are doing press conferences from Gaza are already shuhada. Some of the people that are still talking to us in this dunya are already shuhada, but they don't know. Some of us, and we pray that that's the case, may have earned our Jannah a few years ago. Maybe it was a Laylatul Qadr, maybe it was a sincere moment of tawbah, but are you sure? We don't know. But certainly, some of those people in Gaza that are still alive are already shuhada. They're already to the rank of martyrs. And there were people like that in the time of the Prophet ﷺ. Imagine Nusayba radiallahu ta'ala anha walking around and her arm was not functional for over a year. It was almost severed in the Battle of Uhud when she was in front of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So where is that arm? What part of that person is already experiencing the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised? The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walks by a man by the name of Amr ibn al-Jamuh radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Amr ibn al-Jamuh was one of the chiefs of Medina, first the staunch opponent of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but then came around. And he was an old man at the Battle of Uhud, and he had a significant limp that he used to walk with. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walks by him, and he looks at him, and you say, that leg is already in Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stops as he looks at his dead body, and he says, كَأَنِّي أَرَاكَ بِرِجْلِكَ هَذِهِ صَحِيحَةً فِي الْجَنَّةِ. It's like I see you right now walking in Jannah without that limp. SubhanAllah, the limp is gone. I see that leg of yours that wasn't functional and you're just strolling in Jannah. Allah Azza wa Jal accepted that part of him for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in its entirety. Can part of you precede you to Jannah? Something that was already taken from you can indeed precede you to Al-Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is already allowing it to wait for you. The bushra, the glad tidings of an eventual future entrance. Now, is it just pain or is there a proactive element of this? Is it just when something horrific is inflicted upon you or is there a proactive element to this? Something you did, something you gave, or something that was taken away from you? Remember when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called upon Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu? And here are the words that he said to Bilal precisely. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Ya Bilal, bima sabaqtani ila al-jannah, ma dakhaltu al-jannata qat, illa sami'tu khashkhashataka amami. O Bilal, what is it that caused you to be ahead of me, to be preceding me? And of course, the rank of the Prophet ﷺ is greater, but when Rasulullah ﷺ is in Jannah, he hears the footsteps of Bilal radiallahu anhu in front of him. And he says, مَا دَخَلْتُ الْجَنَّةِ قَتْ. Every time Allah has allowed me to experience Jannah in the way that He allowed me to experience it, every single time, Bilal radiallahu anhu's footsteps are in front of me. What is it, O Bilal? How are your footsteps already there? And Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, Ya Rasulullah, the only thing I could think of is that every time I make wudu, I pray two rak'ahs. Those two rak'ahs that I put forth every single time I make wudu. So his footsteps are already there for the footsteps that he used to make to wudu and the footsteps that he used to take to salah. Can you think of, can you, subhanAllah, imagine your footsteps to the masjid already in Jannah? Being heard in al-Jannah? And they're waiting for you if they're sincere footsteps. So just as there are homes in Jannah, just as there are trees that are built with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gardens that are completely harvested with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with those good deeds, with the charity that you do in this life, all of these properties, there could be a part of you that's already preceded you there and you're just waiting. And certainly, that would be the case for many of these awliya, many of these salihin, many of these righteous friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are in Gaza right now. So it's pain, it's efforts, it's something that you do, it's something that you give. And I want you to pay attention to these last few ahadith. There's a very famous hadith where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talks about the most precious thing that's taken away from a person. And it is a child. The most precious thing that's taken away from a person. You know, if you've heard people say and felt that a piece of me has broken, has died in the last 2 months, right? Imagine a person now who's not on the casualty count, but has buried every single person beloved to them, or lost a child, even one child. And what is life after that? What is the sweetness of life after you've buried your child? How do you even experience it at that point? And look at the hadith, what Allah Azza wa Jalla says to the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَبَطْتُمْ وَلَدَ عَبْدِي. Did you take the child of my servant? Yes. And the next question is, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, قَبَطْتُمْ ثَمَرَةَ فُؤَادِهِ. Did you take the fruit of his heart? Like you took a piece of that person. SubhanAllah, the wording is so profound that Allah Azza wa Jalla is asking the angels, a piece of that person's heart, the fruit of his heart or the fruit of her heart is gone. It's preceded them. And the angels say, yes, O Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ماذا قال عبدي? What did my slave say? حمدك واسترجع الحمد لله إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. Have you seen those people? Have you seen those people in Gaza? Alhamdulillah, hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. While the children are still fresh in their hands, and they're still able to say that, you're witnessing this hadith in action. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says to the angels, ibnu li abdi baytan fil jannah, wa samuhu bayt alhamd. Go ahead and build for that slave of mine a palace in paradise and call it the house of praise. Call it baytul hamd. But there is more. What's happening to the child at this point? You see, it's the ajr. The ajr is baytul hamd. The ajr is a home of praise. But you've set a piece of yourself forward. Something was ripped out of you and taken to another realm. In another hadith in Mustadrak al-Hakim, it's an authentic hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, أَوْلَادُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي جَبَلٍ فِي الْجَنَّةِ يَكْفُلُهُمْ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَسَارَةَ حَتَّى يَرُدَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ آبَائِهِمْ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Prophet ﷺ said that the children of the believers, now all children that would die before the age of puberty are not accountable. They have the reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what about the believers who sent forth their children, whose children were taken away from them? He said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that the children of the believers are on a mountain outside of or in Al-Jannah, around the outskirts of Al-Jannah. يَكْفُلُهُمْ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَسَارَةُ. Ibrahim and Sarah are taking care of them. Ibrahim and Sarah are taking care of them until they give them back on the Day of Judgment. What more do you want than that? That the parents know that their child transitions and they are in the hands of our father Ibrahim alayhi salam and his wife, taking care of them, giving them that warmth until the Day of Judgment when they find their parents in front of the gates of Jannah and insist on entering them into Al-Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow all of those who have suffered this tremendous loss to realize this tremendous reward. Allahumma ameen. So a piece of you could be taken, a piece of your heart, one of your limbs, something taken away from you. But what it comes down to, something you did, something you gave, something or someone that was taken away from you. And so the only question, subhanAllah, that you ask yourself, what has preceded me to Al-Jannah? Of me and from me. What has preceded me to Al-Jannah, of me and from me? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us all to enter into Al-Jannah, into Al-Firdaus Al-A'la, with our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the righteous ones, with the people of Gaza, with the people that came before us, with the people that will come after us. Allahumma ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'il al-muslimin fastaghfiru innahu al-ghafur rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين ولا عاقبة للمتقين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب دعوات اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واعف عنا ولا تعذبنا ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اللهم اغفر لوالدينا رب ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في فلسطين اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في فلسطين اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والكاذبين ودمر أعداء الدين اللهم أهلك الظالمين بالظالمين أخرجنا وإخواننا من بين المسالمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على النعماء يزد لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة